So many families do not have a designated guest room for friends or relatives coming to visit. Seattle interior designer Carrie Peterson's work has been featured on the HGTV show House Hunters, as well as in magazines like Domino and Seattle Magazine. And she's here to share some easy and inexpensive ways to quickly turn a messy kid's room into a welcoming space for guests. It's like, Shazam, we can do this.
Yes, we can, Margaret.
We can do this. And most people don't have just a dedicated guest room. They might have an office or, yep. You know, a kid's room where the child's going to sleep in the parents' room for a while and the guests go in there.
Yep.
So let's talk first of all about your work. We have some various things have been featured on House Hunters and in Domino Magazine, etc. So there's a kitchen before and after that I want people to see that you did just a beautiful job on.
Yes, this is a beautiful home in Queen Anne that needed a lot of love. And I have a great contractor that I work with, so we brought our crew in, and yeah. There's
oh
the magic.
My gosh,
there's
that
the
looks
magic.
So pretty.
Yes.
The brick and the textures.
Yes, uncovering that exposed brick was a game changer.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
It was there. It was just covered
up. It
was
up. Always
Isn't that
there.
Something?
Yeah.
Okay, so a bathroom next. Lovely. So you started with this.
Yeah, we started with this.
And we turned it into,
yes.
Oh my gosh.
Yes, a lovely.
It looks like a spa.
It really did have a spa feel. Yeah, I was really happy with that. How
I
that
can just
turned
tell
out.
It smells good from looking at it.
Oh, doesn't it?
It smells
yes.
good in
oh,
there.
Yeah.
It's minty
yeah.
fresh.
Uh-huh.
And then now some magazine stuff that you put together. It looks so fun. I love your use of color in this.
Yeah, I'm. You know, our sky here is so gray. We have a lot of gray days, so I'm all about color.
I agree with you.
Yeah.
When we moved into our house, it was all gray, and I went, no, nothing's going to be gray
yeah.
in the house.
I want to feel like I'm on vacation in my home, and I
yeah.
want my clients to have the same feeling.
And have a good feeling
yeah.
about that. Okay, so let's talk about the tricks, and we have a lot of things
yes,
here.
Yes, the tricks.
You and I were just bonding over our love of anthropology
yeah. oh,
for cool
the best home stuff. The best
accessory
stuff.
Stuff and good sales for that
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, they really
too,
do.
So don't,
all
please,
the time.
You know, don't feel like you have to break the bank.
Yes.
Okay, so we've got a messy kid's room or
yep.
just a kid's room. You know, it looks like this most of the time.
Yeah, that's a kid's
and
room.
And you're going to, you know, presto change-o. What's our process?
Okay, so my trick is basically a guest room in a box. So
I love it.
I use this under the bed storage piece, which is super fancy because it's on wheels.
Brilliant.
And what you can do is have all the items for your guest room in here and then keep it stored under your kid's bed.
I love that.
Yeah, so when your guest is about to come, you take it out and then take all of your items out, and then you can take the excess kids' toys, the Legos, the Pokemon cards, just put it all in there and then hide it
and
away.
Back under the bed.
Yes, yes.
You're brilliant. Okay, so what's in my magic bin?
Well, I want to say first start off with some guest-only towels and guest-only sheets. If that's the only thing you buy, definitely invest in that because your guests, they don't want to sleep on your kids' Paw Patrol sheets.
Probably not.
The
they
sheets
like
have
Ninja
been through
Turtles.
Things. We don't, you know, we don't want to subject anybody
the
to that.
The sheets have seen some things.
Yes,
let's
exactly.
not do it.
So if you invest in those only, a lot of the stuff you can borrow from other areas of your home.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Very good. So sheets and towels.
Yes.
Then what?
Okay, so I like to start with a picture frame. And put a picture of you and your guest on the nightstand.
It just if you've got one, that is so cool.
Yes,
such
it just
a welcoming
lets them
thing.
Know that you're thinking about them. I always like to have some sparkling water for my guests
mm-hmm.
and a snack as well. Because I know I've stayed at a home where I didn't feel comfortable getting up in the middle of the night and raiding anybody's fridge.
You feel like a creeper, but
yes!
they make
Don't
it
Don't be the creeper. So have snacks for your guests. I like to have a few magazines. And usually I put...
Wait, stop. You've got bark fins, which are like my new favorite thing in
I'm
the
obsessed.
Whole wide world. These
They're
are
so good.
Great.
Yes, one for your guests and one for you.
Exactly.
So I like to have a tray at the end of the bed with a couple of magazines, you know, some books, maybe
cool.
a piece of classic literature, and then a beach read, because that's what everyone's going to read anyway.
Right.
A nice smelling candle, perhaps a succulent. I do a little room spray before somebody comes in, but be light-handed with that, because you never know what... smells
what
trigger
like.
People. Yeah.
You've got Meyer's Clean Day. Is that the spray?
Yes, that's
and it
the
just
spray.
smells like
Yeah.
Ooh, it just smells
it
clean.
It smells like not like kid.
A, yeah.
Is what it smells like. So and that's really what you want.
I love that. And the little plant was a brilliant stroke, I thought, because that does give a little life to a room
mm-hmm.
and you don't normally have that when
yeah.
you have a kid's room. And you've got a little comforter there, so maybe something that ties it all together and makes
yes.
it look a little more grown up.
Yes.
Okay, let's talk about when the kids are coming back into the room, then all this goes away. Yeah. Kids' stuff comes back out. It's as simple as that, right?
Yes. So I did this with a client the other day, and I timed myself, and I was in and out in 17 minutes. So
Are you kidding?
I'm not about to do anything that's not really easy. We're all very busy.
Right.
So just have it all in one spot. And the thing is that these things will wear, they will, what I'm trying
They'll
to
last
say.
For a long time.
They'll last for a long time because you only use them when guests come.
Right. Very yeah. good. Let's take a look at a before after, and then where are some of your other places that you go to kind of get some of these special items? So there's before, and look!
Yes!
There's
it's
after.
It's instant guest room. Isn't that great?
That really is.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, I love to shop for towels at both Crate and Barrel, and Restoration Hardware has the best towels. I'm definitely shopping for sheets at Pottery Barn. A lot of these items you can also get at Target. So mm-hmm. don't feel like you have to make a huge investment.
Target has some great pieces.
Target has
and
everything.
There's sales at all the places
all
you
the
mentioned.
Time. All the time.
Shop
and, like, and things like the candle and the books and the picture frames, you already have those.
Right. I love that idea because we're just moving that from someplace else mm-hmm. into the guest room. We don't have to run out and buy something new, but yeah. it makes such a big difference.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Being a guest at your house must be lots of fun.
We do have fun. There's like a lot that. Of color. There's yeah. a lot of life, and yeah, we have fun.
Awesome. Thank you very much. I like that. I like the under the bed box a lot.